80% of the companies don't have information quick enough to make a decision. 95% of the product launches fail because they simply build a product that no one needs. So we all know how to solve this problem. Basically, we need to know really what does the consumer think. However, this is how the consumer market is working today. A typical consumer research market takes 2 to 3 months to produce a report to you. The cost can easily rack up to 100,000 ringgit. The methodology that is used is often outdated and the data it provides you may be inaccurate. So here's how we're changing it. We are launching a new product into the market that allows any organizations from Fortune 500 companies to local startups to be able to ask questions to consumer and get back 400 responses as fast as 2 hours. So what we can help you is that we connect you directly to 350,000 people that is real identity, real people that is validated. And the reason why we can do this well is because of 2 reasons. First, we have our own panel. So this all panel are people who already know their identity verified by officer checks. Secondly, we employ technology in every single process. First, a lot of people may not know how to necessarily ask the right questions. Second, we may not really know who to target best, and third, we may not know how to interpret the results. This is where we put in technology in terms of built-in recommended insights, in terms of helping you to identify what is the best question to ask, considering your business objective, and also what insights can it be derived based on statements. This brings value to organizations where companies like Baskin Robbins, their marketing team can find out what does the millennial think about their brands. For DG, the product team can find out that's actually DG prepaid products because people really want it. So this brings a different perspective in terms of now, not only people with data analysis knowledge, such as researchers, can do research, but now every one of us can also be data driven. This is the team behind it. So we have our Ash, our CTO, who have built apps that support more than 10 million users before this. We have our COO, Zen, who hit our respondents team. And built from 0 to 350,000 single-handedly with just growth hacking techniques. I run 2 businesses before this, and together in our company, we have 3 data scientists and more than 25 years of market research experience. So the reason why we are the best team in actually launching this product into the market is because in the past 4 years, we actually have been building a digital research company in Malaysia and is now the leading digital research company. From there, we have 70 plus enterprise clients, whereby we learn a lot of different things about what large enterprises really do when it comes to research, and we are doing it by democratizing the market research by producing a market using our product every. We are currently raising $500,000 with the objective to lead to product development and also product commercializations and expanding to Southeast Asia markets. What we see in the market right now is a lot of these brands are trying to capture Southeast Asia market because that's the next $100 billion market. Thank you.
Judges, over to you for questions.
$5,000 on a monthly basis for 5,000 credits. 5,000 credits equals to 5,000 questions. Let's say I ask 1,000 people 1 question, it's 1,000 credits. Usually enterprise we go for higher credits, but our minimum is 5,000. Monthly subscription basis on a per yearly basis is 60K.
Which year? And the sample base that you have, who are the
responses? So 300,000 is in Malaysia, 50,000 in Singapore. Range across entire Malaysia throughout different race, age and gender. However, having said that, the most active one is 18 to 40. So usually our target customers will use us for millennials, digital product and services.
How do you verify the identity of all your people? 350,000 people is quite a lot. How do you verify the identity of all the people that they are in?
IC number. And I pay you. So I need to pay you. You need to give me banking information. And then I will pay you, and I only can pay you well if your IC is verified by the bank. That's how I make sure that it's your one account. However, having said that, we also on top of it have your full name, your email address that is verified, and phone number that's verified. Having said that, that two things, we know that we can create a lot of accounts. Ultimately, we do rely on IC and bank account information.
There's a second follow-on question. How can you guarantee people respond in 2 hours? Is it 2 hours response time?
That's why the quantity of the respondents matter. So we actually have done more than 300 projects before this. It's definitely based on an estimation. So we take based on different criteria of our past projects and estimate it. So we have an algorithm that calculates like this. Take an example. I need to give you 400 in 2 hours. So in the first 10 minutes, if I realize that, oh my god, only 10 people answered. So I can actually switch to send to more people in order to give you more. So basically, our algorithm will, by every minute, keep on charging whether or not we need to send to 4 people in order to reach the 400 people. But at the same time, because they are our assets, we cannot send to more people as well. So we will estimate based on that.